You ever wonder why you wake up and you wonder why you're still alive, so many other people aren't? Why you still have breath in your lungs and there are people that have passed away? There isn't a day that doesn't go by I don't think about when I will pass or why I'm here. This is Mr. William, West Virginia. I'm not trying to bring you a sober word. I'm trying to bring you a word of hope. This is December the 5th, 2018, and I have a word for you on God's mercy. In Psalms 6, it says, "Remember, O Lord, thy tender mercies and thy loving kindness, for they have been ever of old. Remember not the sins of my youth, nor my transgressions. According to thy mercy, remember thou me for thy goodness' sake, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord, therefore will he teach sinners in the way." This is consoling. This is very consoling to me because, you know what? There's not a day goes by that I don't have problems in my head, in my heart. I might say or do something I shouldn't do. And I have to rely on the grace of God through his unfailing mercy. I'm going to read you just several scriptures down through Psalms that will jump out at me as I'm going down. In Psalms 4, it says, "Have mercy upon me and hear my prayer." Psalm 6:2, "Have mercy upon me, O Lord." Same scripture in Psalms 9:13, "Have mercy upon me, O Lord." "Have mercy upon me, O Lord." "Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us," Psalms 33. "For thy mercy is great unto your people," I'm sure. I'm not sure. I'd have to look that one up. 57. That's right. Skip that one. I'm kind of going down my concordance and just looking at scriptures with that say something about mercy. There's one scripture I've been looking all over the place for. I can't find it, but it's one scripture I've always heard my whole life was his mercies are new or his mercies are fresh every morning. I will sing of his mercy and judgment. Psalms, 101. Psalm 100 says his mercy is everlasting. And if you go down to Psalms 130, 31, Psalms 136, it says it so many times, "For his mercy endures forever," forever. When God and the Holy Spirit say that they're doing something forever, that means not till next week. It means forever. His mercy endures forever. We are living and breathing and having our being because of his mercy. Because he sent his son to die on a cross for us to take away our sins. And those sins were taken away. They were the past sins, the present sins, and the sins to come. He took care of all of it. So we are allowed to walk around because of his mercy. You are where you're at right now because God has had mercy on you. David in the Psalms wrote so much about mercy. And you go into the Proverbs, and there's scriptures about mercy. Let not mercy and truth forsake thee. You know, I just want to drive home today that, you know, the old folks, I remember growing up, and I can remember some of the old folks say, "Have mercy, have mercy." You know, we were more conscious of God when we were younger. And I'm not to say that I'm not conscious of him on a daily basis, but our world has become less conscious of a very merciful God, a God that is allowing this planet to continue because there's a time frame in which he's going to send his son back, and not even Jesus knows when that's going to be. So it behooves us to do all we can to stay focused no matter how hard the days get, no matter how off track we might get, to still stay focused on the fact that, my gosh, I'm still here because of his mercy. Thank you, Lord. You know, I drive somewhere anymore. I drive somewhere, I get back, and I just thank God for safe passage, for letting me get there and get back without getting killed in a car accident or getting in an accident for that matter. God is good. He is good, and his mercies endure forever. I pray this blesses you. I pray you walk in the mercy of God today with a little more confidence, okay? Hey, Mr. William, West Virginia, I love you, but more importantly, God loves you. Shalom.